Friends, this is the lecture number 3, and in this lecture number 3 we will solve some question. That question, it has come in your exam. Okay, so what he has asked, f of x is equal to minus pi to 0, you have 0 value, and 0 to pi you have pi value. It means that this function f of x, it is discontinuous at 0. Okay, because less than 0 you have the value of the function is 0, and greater than 0 you have the function the value of the function is pi. It means that this function is discontinuous at 0. Okay, so the Fourier series, it also give you such type of it will also help. Even you have the discontinuous function, then also it express the function with the help of Fourier series. Okay, so here what he has given us this question. Now after then he has asked to deduce. At first you have to write this function in the Fourier series, okay, Fourier series form, and after then you have to deduce this one. Okay, so at first I will find this Fourier series. So what is our task? To calculate the a0, an, and bn, then put the value here. Okay, so at first we will calculate a0. So the interval is from minus pi to pi. Before the interval from 0 to pi, this time the interval is from minus pi to pi. So we will use a0 is equal to 1 upon pi minus pi to pi f of x dx. This is your a0. So now 1 upon pi minus pi to pi. Okay, so we will break this function, we will split this one, minus pi to 0. Why? Because you have two value, minus pi to 0, 0, and 0 to pi, pi. So f of x dx plus 0 to pi f of x dx. So it implies that 1 upon pi. Okay, this function, it is 0 because minus pi to 0, your value, the f of x is equal to 0. So this is 0. Okay, but this is pi, minus 0 to pi you have pi. So plus 0 plus 0 to pi pi dx. Okay, so now integration of this, you will get 1 upon pi. Okay, and this pi, it will come outside, and integration of dx is equal to x, and x 0 to pi. Okay, so after then this pi and this pi cancel, then you got pi minus 0. Pi minus 0 is equal to pi. So you have got a0, you have got a0 is equal to pi. Okay, you got a0 is equal to pi. So now we will calculate an. We will calculate an. So what is an? An is equal to 1 upon pi minus pi to pi. Okay, this time before it was 0 to pi. We have done, this is 0 to 2 pi interval. Here the interval he has given minus pi to pi. F of x cos nx dx. You can write also minus c to c. Then after then what will happen? We will discuss next lecture. Okay, 1 upon pi, and again we will split this one, minus pi to 0 f of x cos nx dx plus 0 to pi f of x cos nx dx. Okay, you know that this value is 0 because minus pi to 0 you have 0 value, so this value is 0. Again 1 upon pi. Okay, 0 plus something, 0 to pi f of x is equal to 0 to pi f of x is equal to pi pi cos nx dx. So this constant, it will come outside, and after then both will cut, then you will get cos nx, integration of cos nx is equal to sin nx. Okay, sin nx upon n, 0 to pi. You must note also, what about the sin nx? The graph of sin is equal to sin 0 is equal to 0, and the graph of cos x is equal to cos 0 is equal to 1. Okay, 0, and this is pi, and this is 2 pi. Okay, this is 3 pi by 2, this is pi by 2. Okay, similarly cos 0 is equal to 1, this is pi by 2, and this is pi. Okay, and this is 2 pi. Okay, so this is cos x graph, this is sin x graph. Okay, so here we are just talking about sin x. So sin n pi is equal to 0. You can see that sin pi is equal to 0, sin 2 pi is equal to 0. So it means that sin n pi is equal to 0, sin 0 is equal to 0. So total 0. Okay, so an is equal to 0. Second time you got an is equal to 0. Okay. Now we will find bn. What about bn? Next time we will find bn. Bn is equal to 1 upon pi integration of minus pi to pi f of x sine nx dx. This interval it is working minus pi to pi. So we are writing this one. Okay. So what about bn? Bn is equal to 1 upon pi. Again we will split this function to minus pi to 0 f of x sine nx dx plus 0 to pi f of x sine nx dx. Okay. So bn is equal to 1 upon pi minus pi to 0. The function f of x is equal to 0. Again you can see minus pi to 0. You have 0 value. 0 into something is equal to 0. 0 plus integration 0 to pi. And 0 to pi you have pi. Okay. This pi it has come outside. And this is sine nx. Sine nx dx. Okay. Now pi and pi cancel. This is okay. Then after then integration of sine x is equal to cos nx upon n. Okay. But integration of sine nx is equal to minus. Okay. This is 0 to pi. Okay. Then after then minus 1 upon n cos n pi minus cos 0. You have got this value. Okay. I am just writing here this portion. Then after then you have got minus 1 upon n cos n pi minus cos 0. Okay. What about cos n pi? Cos n pi means cos pi is equal to minus 1. Cos 2 pi is equal to 1. So whenever you have odd, whenever you have odd term, means cos odd pi is equal to minus 1. Cos even pi is equal to plus 1. Okay, you have two value. So even and odd, whenever this value it has either plus 1 either minus 1. Cos 0 is equal to 1. Okay. If this is plus 1, plus 1, minus 1 is equal to 0. It means that what? Whenever we are getting even. Whenever we are getting even minus, even is equal to plus 1, minus 1 is equal to 0. When? We will write when n is equal to even. When n is equal to even, then bn is equal to 0. When n is equal to odd, then bn is equal to minus 1 minus 1 minus minus plus 2 upon n. You are getting 2 upon n. Okay. So you have two value for bn. Now I am erasing something. So we have got a0 is equal to pi. So after calculation we have got a0 is equal to pi, an is equal to 0, and bn you have two value. If n is even then 0, if n is odd then you have this one. Okay. We will put this value here. Okay, here. So you have f of x is equal to a0. What is a0? A0 is equal to pi by 2. Okay. Then plus integration of n is equal to 1 to infinite. An is equal to 0. An is equal to 0 into cos nx plus summation of n is equal to 1 to infinite. Okay. This is summation. Pi by 2 plus summation of n is equal to 1 to infinite 0 into cos nx plus summation of n is equal to 1 to infinite bn. Bn is equal to, it has two value. Okay. So I will open it. Okay. If n is equal to 1, then you have b1 sine x. If n is equal to 2, b2 sine 2x plus b3 sine 3x plus b4 sine 4x plus up to so on. So you have pi by 2, this is 0. Okay. B1 sin x. What is B1? B1 is 2 upon 1 plus 2 upon 1 sin x. When odd, sorry, when even, then this is 0. This value is 0. This value is odd. So you have this value. So in this condition, B3 is equal to 2 upon 3. 2 upon 3 sin 3x plus 0. Then after then 5. B5 sin 5x. So you have b5 means 2 upon 5 and sine 5x, similarly up to shown. This is your Fourier expansion of this function. Okay, this function. He has given you this question. Now this is the answer. Okay. Now after then he has asked to deduce this one. You must note that this function, it is discontinuous at 0. Okay, if you put pi by 2, okay, this function is has finite discontinuous at x is equal to 0. If you are by putting x is equal to pi by 2, then what will happen? Let we will check. F of pi by 2 is equal to pi by 2 plus 2 upon 1 sine pi by 2 plus 2 upon 3 sine 3 pi by 2 plus 2 upon 5 sine 5 pi by 2 plus up to so on. What about this? You can see that f of pi by 2 means it is greater than 0. It means that you will get this value pi. Pi is equal to pi by 2 plus 2 upon 1. Now this sine pi by 2 is equal to 1. Sine, this is the graph of sine. Sine pi by 2 is equal to 1. 1. Okay, this is 1. Plus 2 upon 3. Sine 3 pi by 2. Sine 3 pi by 2 is equal to pi by 2. This is 3 pi by 2. This is 3 pi by 2. This is pi by 2. This is pi. This is 3 pi by 2. This is 2 pi. So sine 3 pi by 2 is equal to minus 1. So you have minus 1 plus 2 upon 5. Sine 5 pi by 2 is equal to plus 1. Okay. So plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1. This will come here. Pi minus pi by 2 is equal to 2 minus pi by 2 is equal to pi by 2. Okay. This it will come here. Then you got this. This minus this is equal to this. And this portion it will it is out means right side. 2 upon 1. So we are just taking 2 common. Okay, 1. 2 into 1 is equal to 2 and 2 common. Then after 1, 1 plus, sorry, minus 1 upon 3. Minus 1 upon 3. Then plus 1 upon 5. Then 7 will come. Minus 1 upon 7 up to so on. Okay. So 2 will come here. Multiplication. Then 2 will come here. Then you will get at last pi upon 4 is equal to this 1 minus 1 upon 3. Plus 1 upon 5 minus 1 upon 7 up to so on. So you have to find this one. So same question here they have also asked in your previous year questions. You must pause the video and every time solve it, then you will get the exact answer. Okay, so again I will just explain you some different question, then your concept it will be clear. Thank you so much.